Hi friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. In today's video, I have a lot of interesting items to discuss with you. So let's begin this video very quickly, but the students who are coming for the first time, it's my duty to tell them to subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification. Also guys, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes as well as resolve your queries. So if you have any kinds of doubts related to your preparation or any kind of doubt related to the examination, then you can ping us on this channel, and the link of this Telegram channel is in description below. So here is our first question that we will be discussing. SSCBC India Ammunition Project is the joint venture project of India with a country for producing ammunition. Which of the following is the right answer? So we have been given five countries: Brazil, Russia, Israel, USA and Singapore. Which out of these five options, the right answer is Brazil. So guys, with Brazil, this project is going to be conducted. Now, under this project, India and Brazil will jointly produce ammunition, and the ammunition will be produced in Andhra Pradesh, starting from August 2021. So Andhra Pradesh, from August 2021, this project is expected to get off the ground. Now apart from this, the other thing that you should keep in mind is that this CBC company is of Brazil, and guys, do you know that it is the world's second largest manufacturer of ammunition? And this CBC Brazil company has partnered with SS India. So SS is Indian company. So these are some of the facts related to that project. Now apart from this project, there is one more news related to India and Brazil. So are you interested to know that news? Let's discuss that. So recently India and Brazil conducted their first bilateral virtual summit, and in that summit the theme was India's defense sector global outreach for collaborative partnership. So guys, this was the theme of India and Brazil's first summit, first virtual summit, and the summit is a part of a series of webinars. Basically, that was a webinar, and this is one of the webinars among the series of webinars that India is conducting with other countries. And what is the purpose of India conducting these webinars with other countries? The purpose is to make India a defense manufacturing hub and to boost defense exports to 5 billion. So I hope that you remember this target of Indian government to boost the defense exports to $5 billion, and to achieve this goal of 5 billion defense exports, Indian government is pushing Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. So that's all for this question. We have discussed everything, but my question for you here is, you have to tell me the president of Brazil. This is your question for the day. I hope that you will mention your answers in the comment section below. Which of the following organization has released the India Workplace Equality Index, India's first comprehensive benchmarking tool for employers to measure their progress on LGBTQ plus inclusion at the workplace? So clearly the purpose of this India Workplace Equality Index has been given in the question itself. That is, it is a measure that will allow the companies to measure their own efforts towards inclusivity. So this is the first ever edition of this index. Now who has released this index? Is it Kesha Suri Foundation, Pride Circle, Stonewall UK, FICCI, all of the above? I know guys that majority of you are going with option D, FICCI, but the right answer is not that. The right answer is option E, all of the above. So all these four organizations have collaborated to launch this first ever India Workplace Equality Index. Now this is the first edition of this index that has been released, and a total number of 9 parameters were there on which 65 companies were assessed. Out of these 65 companies, 21 companies won the Gold Award. Now, this Gold Award has been given in recognition of their efforts towards towards increasing the inclusion of LGBTQ community. So that's all for this question. I hope that you can remember all the facts that I have told you here. Where was Thai Global Summit 2020 be organized? So basically, where was this Thai Global Summit organized? Guys, do you know that it is claimed to be, or it is considered as, the world's largest ever entrepreneurship event being held on the planet? So remember this thing, it is the world's largest summit so far. And this summit was organized by Indus Entrepreneur. Which is short from DAS, TIE. So this Indus Entrepreneurs has organized this Thai Global Summit 2020, which is touted as the world's largest entrepreneurial summit so far on the planet. Now, where was it organized? It was organized in Hyderabad. So this is an important question. Now guys, apart from these facts, there was another fact that is of major importance here, and that fact is the theme of this summit. So what was the theme? The theme is entrepreneur So this is the theme of this summit. That's all for this question. How much amount has India pledged to Partnership for Maternal, Newborn and Child Health for providing essential services to women, newborns, young children and adolescents across the world? First of all, I would like to tell you that there was a summit that was, there was an event, online event that was organized by WHO, and that event is named as Living in Balance. And on during that event, a total amount of 20.6 billion was pledged for providing the essential health services to women, child, newborns and other people in the humanitarian crisis. So now you have to you have to tell the India's contribution towards it. So India's contribution is $2 billion. Now guys, that was all about the current news. Now we should also focus on the static part of this news, and that static part is related to this partnership. So this partnership is a coalition, is an alliance for the maternal, newborn and child health. Do you know when was it launched? It was launched in the year 2005. And where is it at present? It is located in Geneva, Switzerland. So what is so special about Geneva, Switzerland? Do you know that? Geneva, Switzerland is also the headquarters of WHO. So WHO has the secretariat of this partnership for maternal, newborn and child health. And remember this thing, the secretariat of this partnership is in Geneva, Switzerland. It was launched in 2005, and the purpose of launching it was to promote the health of women, children and newborns. So that's all for this question. Now my question from you is, WHO's Director General, that you have to tell me. Change 5 or Chang'e 5 is the lunar mission of which country? So guys, you must have heard about this mission. It has been in the news for past 1 month. Why is it in the news? The reason behind this is that it is going to return on Earth with moon sample, with rock samples from the moon. Now, for which country will it, or basically which country has launched this lunar mission? So this lunar, this Chang'e 5 lunar mission was launched by China. And now we have discussed the current and the important part of this news. I have some interesting facts as well related to this news. So guys, do you know that Chang'e 5 has recently planted the flag of China on moon? And by doing so, China has become the second country in the world to have its flag on the moon. Do you know which is the first country? It is very obvious. It's US. So during its Apollo 11 mission, you would know that Neil Armstrong was the first person that landed on moon, and he just he planted US moon, American flag on the moon. Now, after this flag planting, China has become the second country in the world. Apart from this, if this mission becomes successful and this Chang'e 5 becomes successful in bringing lunar samples to the Earth, then China will become the third country in the world to have moon samples returned through its mission. So first country was US during Apollo mission. The moon samples were taken back to the Earth. Then the second country is Russia, and the third country is expected to be China. And this is on its way back to Earth. And let's see how successful it is going to be, and can China attain its status of being the third country in the world to have moon samples. That's all for this question. Apart from this, there is one interesting news as well that I want to ask from you. So, do you know that China is also building its own International Space Center? We have one International Space Center, which is a collaboration of many countries. But China is also making its own ISS, and it has given a special name to that as well. So, what is the name of that mission? That you have to tell me in the comment section below. Which of the following organization has signed the Red Channel Agreement with WHO? What is this Red Channel Agreement? That we will discuss after we will know the answer of this question. So let's first discuss the answer. So is it World Bank, European Union, United Nations, International Monetary Fund, or IFRC? So the right answer is IFRC. IFRC stands for International Federation of Red Cross and Crescent, Red Crescent Societies. Now, the IFRS and WHO have signed an MOU, and this MOU is to provide the essential health services to the public in the time of crisis, in the humanitarian crisis. So that is the purpose of this MOU, which is also named as the Red Channel Agreement. So this Red Channel Agreement is nothing but an MOU that has been signed between WHO and IFRC. That is all for this question. Now, do you guys know there is an interesting link between these two organizations? And what is that link? The link is its headquarters. So both these organizations have headquarters at the same location. That is Geneva, Switzerland. So I hope that it helps you in memorizing this question better, and remember this thing, this fact that it is Geneva, Switzerland, where the headquarters of both these organizations are located. And this is the name of this MOU, Red Channel Agreement, that is emergency medical assistance, to provide emergency medical assistance or help to the people who are in need. Next question. Which of the following is the name of the electronic spot platform for agricultural commodities launched by BSE? So BSE stands for Bombay Stock Exchange, and Bombay Stock Exchange has launched an electronic platform for selling or purchasing, for basically for facilitating the trade of agricultural commodities. Now, what is the name of that platform? The name is BSE Agricultural Market. So BEAM, I know that there would be a confusion in your mind regarding BEAM, that is for beaches as well. So I would like to clarify here that B This was India's own certification that was launched to provide launched to give certificates to the cleanest beaches in India. And this beams was also launched in order to encourage beaches to maintain hygiene and sanitation at the beaches. This is different and this is different. This beam stands for BSE Agricultural Market. And what does this beam stand for? This is the thing that you are going to tell me, because we have discussed it. PIP 247 may be discussed kiya gaya tha beams when India got blue flag certification for its 8 beaches. So this is a kind of revision for you guys, or you can say that it is a test for you, that you have to tell me the full form of this beams. Now let's come back to this question. So what is the purpose of this beam? The simple one line purpose is to facilitate trade, electronic trade of agricultural products. And what is the benefit? The benefit is for farmers, for traders, and for every stakeholder involved in this agricultural trading. So that's all for this question. I hope that you have understood what I'm telling. And here this session ends. I hope that you have really enjoyed this session and learned a lot. And please guys, do mention your answers in the comment section below, because it will help you in memorizing the questions better. And secondly, if you have not learned anything and if you have any confusion about anything, then do feel free to ask me in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching the video.